We didn't know the extent of the fire, so when we got there and we had seen how big the fire was, we knew that we needed to act immediately. There were people in trouble, immediate dangers, and we could hear the screams. We could see the people trapped on the third floor balcony. What do we do next? I joined this profession to have a purpose, and that purpose was to help people, help the community, help people in need.
Skyway 10K had 7,000 runners that year. It was towards the end of the race, and we had gotten a call that a vehicle had broken through. She was in excess of 100 miles an hour. You have a threat that is in front of you, and I have people that are behind me that are vulnerable. You just have a few seconds to make a decision.
Officer Peralta and Muhlenberg were operating traffic control. I saw both of them shouting at this car as it careened through. The vehicle was airborne, going down into a ravine.
We just went to work mode, and our main priority was to help whoever is inside.
They're both conscious, alert, breathing.
We're gonna get you guys out.
Highs or lows, it doesn't matter. We're all gonna do what needs to be done.
My name is William Puzynski, and I'm a deputy for the Orange County Sheriff's Office. Orange County Sheriff's Office is one of the largest in the Southeast United States. We got about 2,000 deputies. It gets a little hard every once in a while, though, just because of how big the agency is. But it's also a good thing because there's no limit on what you can do within the agency. There's always room to grow and always room to build. And the camaraderie is great within the agency as well. My primary job on patrol is to respond to calls for service. So if somebody's calling 911, you can assume that they need help. And my goal is to just go out there, respond to the call for service, and figure out how we can assist them in any way, shape, or form. It was a slower night. It was nearing the end of shift. Our shift ends at 5:30 in the morning, and the call had come out at 4 a.m. saying there was a fire to an apartment. We didn't know the extent of the fire, so when we got there and we had seen how big the fire was, we could smell the smoke, and we could hear the screams. And that's when we started looking around at each other. So we knew that we needed to act immediately, and we had to formulate a plan on how we could start safely getting people down. I could hear a baby crying, and that's when I realized that there was a child stuck somewhere, and I was able to look up, and that's when we started noticing Sophie in her mom's arms, and her mom was in a panic trying to figure out what to do with Sophie. And originally, I know she had wanted to drop Sophie just in a panic trying to figure out how to get her down, because she was important. And I knew that wasn't going to work, so that's when we decided we'll have to go up and save her. Due to the extent of the fire, we weren't able to go up the stairwell, so that's when we decided that we were going to climb. And when I started climbing, I just knew I had to figure out how I could safely grab Sophie from her mother. And so originally, when she had tried to pass Sophie on, I didn't have my footing, and I was like, hold on. And then eventually, I was able to get my footing, and I was able to reach up and grab her forearm. And after that, we had got down. I had passed Sophie off, and then I knew that it wasn't over because there was still people up there in danger. And thankfully, the Orange County Fire Department was arriving on scene, and we were just trying to figure out how we could assist them in helping everybody else get down safely. When it had finally sunk in what we had done, it did feel good because it's not every day that, you know, we get to help a family or a person in need, especially to that magnitude. So when we had all come together and talked about it the next day, we realized that we were able to not only save a baby, but we were able to save multiple people and multiple families. I've seen Sophie's mom. I think I've seen her twice since the fire. Yeah, we were actually at a convenience store. And then she had just run up and gave me a hug, and I was like, I took a step back for a second because I didn't realize it was her. And then when I did realize it was her, we had a pretty good conversation for a few minutes. According to her, you know, everything's going smoothly. The apartment complex put her in a new apartment, and they're getting everything back together. So now that I'm expecting a child, when I do look back on this call, I would say it makes a pretty big difference. I'm able to see how important it was to Sophie's mother that we were able to help not only Sophie, but her entire family as well. So it definitely makes a difference.
My name is Galen Schmidt. I'm a police officer with the Reno Police Department.
My name is Devynn Muhlenberg. I'm also a police officer with the Reno Police Department.
Sean Peralta. I'm also an officer with the Reno Police Department.
I was born and raised in the area. Grew up over in Sparks. Been here most of my life. I just have a lot of history with all different parts of the city. You feel more connected, I think, sometimes, and it's important to me to be a part of my community.
And same thing with Galen, just being raised here and the community that raised me basically and gave me everything I am today, I wanted to give back to him.
It was early Saturday morning, approximately 5 a.m. It was the end of our shift. We were working a vehicle versus pedestrian accident in the area of North Virginia and Talus Way. We were holding the scene for detectives to come out there for evidentiary purposes.
As I was finishing up some paperwork in my car, my windows were cracked and I could hear an engine like revving at high RPMs. And as I looked over, I saw both of them shouting at this car as it careened through our traffic control. Didn't hit anything or anybody, but as I flipped to my right side, the vehicle's airborne, going down into a ravine. Peralta and Muhlenberg were already sprinting down. I jumped out of my car and started running.
It was game on then. We just went to work mode, and our main priority was to help whoever is inside. These two immediately jump in and start pulling on doors. I was trying to get on the radio and ask for a window break. I was trying to ask for fire to bring things, but everybody on the radio, all they could hear was that horn.
And right when I hit the water, it kind of took my breath away on how cold it was. And I knew if I was cold, they were gonna be even colder. My initial reaction was just trying to get the doors open, making sure no one's, you know, unconscious or if their head's in the water. So immediately we go to the driver's side of the vehicle.
So I jumped in and I started pulling on the front door. I could not get that open by myself because the front end of the car had lodged itself into the sand. So I was pulling by myself against sand. Peralta started helping me.
I tried to use my glass brake to try and break the driver's side window out, but it was submerged in water, so it was really hard to break the window and get that momentum. That's when Officer Schmidt gave me his baton to try and kind of jab the window out. That was unsuccessful, and so then we just tried yanking on that driver's side door.
While we were prying the door open, Officer Muhlenberg was able to pull the passenger out of the car. And then Officer Peralta helped her drag that passenger out of the water, just to the edge of the ravine. And I assisted the passenger out, kind of walked him over to the edge of the water. And then I asked him, hey, can you walk up this hill? We got to get up to the paramedics. And he's like, no, I can't walk. So I picked him up and just carried him up the hill to the ambulance. And at that point we had fire and paramedics there, and they were able to get down and get to the driver.
So I received this thank you letter in my mailbox, and it states, please know that many people support and appreciate all law enforcement. Thank you for your dedication and sacrifice in this service to our community.
Reno PD interacts with the community in a very positive manner. We're a very community-based organization, and we base everything that we do off of the community's needs and desires and what they're actually requesting. So we take their comments and concerns into consideration with everything that we do.
The brotherhood and sisterhood that we have here is nothing like I've ever experienced before. Everyone here is willing to help and give resources to one another, because we all have the same mindset at the end of the day, is work hard and do a good job for our community.
Public service to me means meeting people where they're at in the community. Whether that's helping an old lady across the street during busy traffic or pulling people out of a car that's upside down in a ravine. Big and small, we're here to do it, and I think we all look forward to doing it each and every day.
To get recognition for this call is a really good feeling. That doesn't go without saying that our partners in other shifts or whatnot don't do the same work. It just happened that this one came to light. I feel like the department is moving forward and showing the community what not just us, but all of us do as a whole every single day, which is a positive impact on the community, and it's just a really good feeling.
My name is Toni Schuck, and I'm a Master Trooper with the Florida Highway Patrol. So I work in the Troop C area. And that area consists of the seven counties, and it's heavily populated. So primarily what I do is commercial vehicle enforcement and specifically hazardous materials. So I not only enforce state laws, I enforce the federal laws that govern commercial vehicles. And I want to make sure you get from point A to point B safely, and everybody around you. Every year for the past 5 years, they've held the Skyway 10K, which is put on by the Armed Forces Foundation. The 2022 Skyway 10K had approximately 7,000 runners that year. The race takes place over the iconic Skyway Bridge, which spans from Pinellas County into Manatee County. I had arrived about 11 o'clock the night before the race was to start, and it was an uneventful evening till about 8:45 that morning. The south end of our detail had sent a radio transmission that a vehicle had broken through the detour and was traveling northbound in our direction. When I got the call on the radio, I was originally facing the Skyway Bridge, and initially all I did was just turn my truck around because I knew there was a couple more checkpoints. In my mind, I figured she was going to stop. And then a few seconds later, there was another radio transmission where the officers that were pursuing the driver to try and get her to stop stated that she wasn't stopping. She was in excess of 100 miles an hour and that she was pulling away from them and they were losing sight of her. So at that point, the hairs on the back of my neck stick up and you get a knot in your stomach and you're like, okay, you know, what's this driver's intention? Where are we going with this? At that point, you just have a few seconds to make a decision on what you're gonna do. And I just decided that the only thing I could do at this point with the truck that I had was obstruct the road in an attempt to get her to stop. She came towards me and from my point of view, she started to veer to the left, so I veered my truck to the left. She then started veering to my right, I veered to the right, and then within the last few seconds, for whatever reason, she made the decision to straighten out her vehicle and she hit me head on. So after the collision, panic sets in. I can't get out of the truck, so there's that little bit of panic. You're always worried about a car catching on fire. There wasn't pain immediately. It wasn't until after I got out of the car and was pretty much walked away from the truck and I actually saw the truck directly in front of me. And then you see the other vehicle and you realize how significant and how intense the crash was. So after the crash, I was obviously injured. She was injured. I was taken by ambulance over the Skyway Bridge. As I was going over the bridge, in the back of the ambulance, they have the two windows. And when I went over the bridge, I'm gonna get upset because I always think about this. I saw people. I saw people still on the bridge. And it made me realize that had she not stopped, she could have hurt him. So to be on the other side of the call is a little bit different. Being the victim of an alleged drunk driver, there's a sense of vulnerability. With me, it was, you know, I have a career, I have a job, am I gonna be able to go back to doing what I was doing? But I was determined that I knew I only had a few years left, hopefully I retire. But I knew I was gonna come back on my terms, that I wasn't gonna let somebody who made a decision and that decision caused injury to me to determine when I retire, if it was a medical retire. So I fought hard to come back to work so that I could continue my career on my terms. So my goal as a trooper in the state of Florida is community service. It's get to help the community in whatever way it is. So if it's coming out here on these roads and changing a tire, or if it's stopping somebody for speeding and getting them to slow down, every day is a different experience. So ultimately it's making an effect in our community. Like I said, you live in the moment and every day is a blessing. I just need to live in the moment and be a mom and a wife and a state trooper.